When you eat, food is broken down into smaller particles in the mouth, then pushed through the esophagus and dropped into the stomach. Here, the chemical and mechanical digestion continues, breaking the food down into glucose, or sugar.
Glucose is a form of energy that our body uses. We need glucose to function.
As the partially digested food moves through the small intestine, glucose is absorbed into the bloodstream and travels throughout the body. The pancreas is an organ located behind the stomach that makes insulin.
The pancreas secretes insulin in response to the food entering the intestinal system. And once it gets to the bloodstream, the insulin's there to take care of it, to get it from the blood into the cells.
The insulin travels through the body, acting like a key to unlock the door to each cell. When the cell door is open, glucose can enter. Once inside, glucose is used for energy, allowing the cell to work properly. In type 1 diabetes, the body attacks the insulin-producing cells, and the pancreas can no longer produce insulin. Without insulin, glucose is unable to get into the cells to be used for energy.
Type 1, usually happens suddenly, and people's blood sugars are very elevated when they're diagnosed.
In type 2 diabetes, the pancreas can make insulin, at first. After you eat, the pancreas senses the blood glucose levels are up, so it releases insulin. The insulin travels through the body and tries to unlock the door to each cell, but it can't. Glucose builds up in the blood.
So for a while, the body will compensate and put out extra insulin in response to this carbohydrate or glucose load into the blood.
Eventually, the pancreas gets worn out and insulin production slows down. When a person with diabetes has too much glucose in their blood, it becomes thicker and grittier. This can cause damage to arteries, nerves, eyes, kidneys, and more. That's why it's so important for a person with diabetes to learn how to control their blood sugar to help prevent long-term health problems.